Okay. There is a number of questions here, 11 questions. This one doesn't make any sense. So 10 questions that I will try to answer. And just one notification prior to start, there is nothing more in PDF file than this. This is the only thing that exists there. So why would you buy it? There is no reason for it except to donate something or what. Okay, let us start from the start. Please explain why these are true, false, or always true, false. Okay. In a capacitor, in alternated current circuit, the electric field leads the current. Capacitor, sad ćemo imamo. A si, šta ide? Electric field leads the current. Capacitor. IC. Current leads voltage. That is in capacitor. This is hyperphysics. And this is about phases. Phasor diagrams and so what's not. So when you have capacitors, current leads voltage. Okay. Second, the impedance of a capacitor increases with frequency. This is false. Why is that? Because impedance with the capacitor, you could Google it, decrease with frequency. So larger your frequency have, the less resistance is in the capacitor. Direct current, for instance, is something, let's say, alternating current with a period of God knows what, and the capacitor have infinite resistance to direct current. So more frequency, less resistance for the capacitor, of course. In LR circuit, that is induction coil resistance circuit with a switch, the current throughout the inductor when the switch has been closed has long times. What the fuck? In LR circuits, switch the current throughout the inductor when. No, doesn't matter. Current goes throughout the inductor all the time and creates magnetic field, but why there would be no current there? The voltage across capacitor in directed current circuit approach its final value exponentially. That is correct, and you could Google it. Why is that happening? Because when you have capacitor that is, let's say, connect to some battery, this battery will use some chemical work to place more and more positive charges on this plate. So this battery will take positive charges from here and transport them to there. And as you can imagine, next positive charge that needs to be transported will be attracted to this and repulsed by that. So it resists. And you need to find some external work that is battery chemically operated or the dynamo machine or whatnot. So the longer time it progresses, the current is exponentially decreased. Because of that, an equation you could find. To make higher pass filter, the user it's a circuit with the output voltage measured across capacitor. This is false. And why is that? It has high pass filter. High pass, that means to large frequencies. Use an RC circuit with an output voltage. I can't remember why did I answer that false. Google this high pass filter and see what's going on. You will probably get some equation that will show you that is false. Okay. In an RC circuit, the electric and magnetic field reach their maximum values at the same time. That is false. But of course, there is false because the resistance and actually, that is, and the capacitor magnetic field reach their maximum. Electric and magnetic field. Let me see. Electric and magnetic field. Is the maximum value at the same time. Okay, why is that problem? Maximum current will yield maximum magnetic field. But when the current stops, after some while, current will stop. And there will be no magnetic field at all, but there will be an electric field here between this and maximum electric field. So maximum electric field corresponds to the minimum magnetic field in this situation. So magnetic field around this conductor will be max at its maximum at the start, when the current is strongest. But at the end, when the current stops, the magnetic field is zero, and the electric field between those two plates are maximum. So that is not the same time, it is opposite. And now, the transformer, no energy loss, the side with more turns gives the higher voltage, that is, and larger current, the side with the fewer turns. This is true, this is false. Why is that? Because this is primary and secondary, primary and secondary, primary and secondary. This is how relate. This is the number of turns, this is the current, this is the voltage. It can be higher voltage and larger current. This is opposite. As you can see, higher voltages correspond to the... So now it doesn't matter if you have in primary larger number of the turns. If this is larger, so larger voltage, smaller current. If this is smaller, the smaller voltage, larger current. So these two things are not compatible with each other. One is high when the other is low, and vice versa. And the eighth, the inductance of the coil depends on the number and size of the coils, the material, and the wire. Of course, that is right there in the equation for inductance. L is equal whatnot. L, E, omega, and whatnot. And you will see that it depends on that, of course. The capacitance of a capacitor, material in the wire, in a way it won't. Capacitance 9. Capacitance of the capacitor is decreased by the place material with high electric constant between those two plates. No, it actually increases. If you have high electrical constant, let's say that you could store additional charges here, because they are in a way annihilated by the charges, by separation in charges within the electric material. This term, like resistor, inductors in series capacitance series, while inductors, so this is those two, this equation is doesn't make any sense, so forget about it. Once the initial phasors for 8 alternate current circuits are plotted, they each rotate at different rates as time progresses. This is false. Once you plot these phasors, they rotate one in front of each other, one in front of another, but the period of the rotation is the same. So they do not rotate in a different time. So, as you can see here, distance from this point is equal to this distance from this point to this point. So it's the same period. Or distance from here to here is equal to this here to here. But they are one in front of another. The distance is the same. No, distance is not the same, but yes, distance, but this is the time. Or we could see here, this is the current, this is the voltage. Sometimes it's in the inductor, voltage leads current, in the capacitor, current leads voltage. But this is the phase that represents that. And this is how the amplitude increases with the time and whatnot. And here you can see, nice, this is one wavelength, this is time. And as you can see, okay, this is phase shift. Distance from here to here is equal to distance from here to here. So, and what leads what here? You tell me. Okay, this is maximum amplitude here, this is amplitude of the current. It's not too difficult to understand. And sinus is used only for the phase shift. As you can see, that is the same frequency, but there is a phase shift that is shifted to the right, so to speak, for 30 degrees. Why are we using sinuses? We could use sine or cosine, but we will have different phase shift. Let's say we use a sine. Why? Because this is mathematical construction that takes values from minus 1 to plus 1. And if you place in front of this amplitude, when this is a plus 1, it will be up there. When this is minus 1, it will be downwards and somewhere in between, and all values in between. And that is useful mathematical tool. That is what we are using sinus and cosine for this. Speculations. Now this, what is it? This is the connected to the number 10 question. When you have capacitors, they are in parallel capacitor, equivalent capacitances when you add them, and for the inline when you add them like this. One, this is the equivalent capacitance, this is C1 and C2. For the resistors, is the other way around. When you have parallel resistors, they add like this. This is the equivalent resistance, this is all the two, and when they are in line, they are like this. And when you have inductor is similar to the capacitor in that sense that equivalent induction is for parallel at this like, and for the, no, this is actually, no, this is like a resistor. Inductor is similar to the resistor in this way, not capacitor. As you can see, for parallel is 1 divided by L equivalent, and this for the inline is just L when you add them together. So if you find out what the question was for the 10, you could deduce the answer from this. So again, thank you for watching. This is only everything that you have in PDF files, so nothing more. But if you need to if you have wish to donate, please do so. For complete written answer, please follow the link in the description. If you want more of this, please subscribe and tell your friends. Thank you. Bye.